मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, कैसे हैं आप सब और कैसी चल रही है रोज की जिंदगी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट पीरियड्स एंड द थ्री दोषास। विच साइकिल ड्यूरिंग द मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल, कौन से पीरियड में कौन सा दोष डोमिनेंट रहता है और हमें क्यों जरूरत है कीपिंग अ बैलेंस इन आवर बॉडी ड्यूरिंग आवर पीरियड्स एंड हाउ डू यू बैलेंस द थ्री दोषास। Alright, so we need to understand that when we menstruate, we are in the Vata part of the menstrual cycle. This is because Vata is the energy that governs the movement and flow. And Ayurveda encourages us to support the downward flow of this energy so that we support ourselves in the clearing of the menstrual blood from our bodies. This is also why many of you must have heard the yoga teachers and the Ayurveda practitioners discouraging us from practicing inversions while you're menstruating. In all that you do and feel at this time, remind yourself that it is healthy to let it out, to let it go, to let it be. This is a time of release and clearing, and your body feels that, ladies, on every single level. Now, after menstruation, kapha period is dominant. The kapha dosha is dominant. This part of the cycle lasts from the end of the bleeding phase to the point at which you prepare to ovulate. The kapha phase overlaps slightly with the vata phase. We need to understand it like moon rising as the sun sets on the similar way. Now, during the kapha phase, all of those typically kapha energies come into play. The endometrium thickening, a sense of tending, nourishing and preparing the inner soil for what is to come. And when we often feel fuller in our bodies at this time, we feel more softer, more curvier, more supple, a beautiful realizing of our feminine energy. At the point of ovulation, we enter the pitta phase of the cycle. This is when the endometrium becomes fully engorged and filled with blood, ready to receive the ovum. We can feel warmer, more prone to sweating, and increasingly hot-tempered at this time. Many women also feel a greater drive to do, create, socialize, and achieve at this time. So the ambitious motivating energy of Pitta supporting us at this time of the month. Now, if the ovum is not fertilized, the cycle begins anew with one day of menstruation when the body once again clears and opens and we move once more into the Vata phase of our cycle. If you've seen this way, the delicate flow from bleeding to receiving, from earthed and fleshy kapha abundance to airy and cleansing vata lightness, our bodies begin to feel more like intuitive symphonies of energy and subtlety. And perhaps if we begin to take a little more time to honor the magic behind the mechanics, we will find ourselves far more accepting of this highs and lows, ebbs and flows too. Very, very important for all of us to understand these phases of our menstrual cycle, because that is when we will be conscious about it and take care of it. Now that you've understand the phases, it's important for you all to understand the importance of keeping all the doshas correctly. And that's why very, very important for us to have progressive detox in our body. A lot of ladies tell me, I'm following specific diets, but there are no changes in my periods. I still feel low in energy. I still feel, tired. I still feel no periods or absent of periods or scanty bleeding or heavy bleeding or pain. That is because you've not detoxed your body, and without detoxing your body, you're still working towards eating right. Till the time the toxins are out from our body, the micronutrients will not get absorbed. So the step one is to detox our body, and there are great ways. There are ways to detox through food, and that is what you should be doing. Number two, देन स्टार्ट ईटिंग राइट. नंबर थ्री, इम्पॉर्टेंट इम्पॉर्टेंट टू मेंटेन आर जठर अग्नि विच इज द डाइजेस्टिव फायर. And that's why it's important to have your cycle of food, your biological clock, sync with the sun. A lot of us use the westernized way of waking up to fruits. We are eating those mueslis. Is that the right food to eat the first thing in the morning? Something to think about, and I'll do a video on that too. Then comes your sleeping pattern. Very, very important, because in that deep REM is when your hormones, the quality of hormones, are produced. So please take care of your sleep. And the most important, ladies, we love to take every sort of stress. And stress really impacts our doshas. It really impacts our hormones. So very, very, very important to take care of that. I hope now that you've understood the cycle, you will be more cautious and you will take care of each phase of your life. Please embrace your periods, enjoy your periods, and understand that it's a very important aspect of a woman's life for the woman's health. If you're not getting your periods, take it seriously. Work towards getting that cycle every single month. I shall see you tomorrow. Take care.